Hello everybody, hope you're all doing well. Welcome to a new episode of The Return. Today we're gonna train some legs and I'm gonna share with you guys the three tips to build bigger legs. So without further ado, let's get into it. Okay, tip number one, don't forget to train your adductors and your hamstrings because they will give your leg the full round look if you look from the front or from the back. People focus a lot on just training their quads, but you need that inner thigh as well. So don't forget to train your adductors. That's gonna be your first exercise for today. We're gonna do some adductor work. We're trying to get it nice and intense and heavy, such as you would do with all your other leg muscles as well. So let's get into it. We're gonna do two sets here, a little bit in the higher rep range. The first set is gonna be 8 to 12, and the second set is gonna be 15 to 20 reps. Let's go. Okay, it's time for working set number one, 8 to 12 reps. But because the stack is too light for me to fail in that rep range, we're gonna use the gym pin. It's a very crafty thing you can get from gym pin. I believe gym underscore pin on Instagram, so check that out. So what we're gonna do is pop this one in. We're gonna add some plates to that. I actually need to order a bigger gym pin because I can't fit more plates on, so we're gonna add a dumbbell as well. That looks solid, doesn't it? Alright, so here we go, 8 to 12. Okay, time for set number two. This time we're going a little bit lighter because we're going up in reps. So it's 15 to 20 reps on the full set plus added 35. That's the full 20 reps. Exercise number two, seated hamstring curls. I basically do most isolation work today before my compounds because I want to pre-fatigue them. That way I can get the most out of a lower volume. If you are a beginner, I would not suggest you do this. However, if you are advanced, this might be something that brings you to the next level. Two sets here, one of 8 to 10 and one of 12 to 15. So let's get to it. Yeah. exercise number three. Now we're moving on to the quad. We're gonna do leg extensions. We got two sets here. One is gonna be 8 to 12, and the second one is gonna be 15 to 20 again. So let's burn. Set number one. Two, 15 to 20 reps. Let's see how far I get, because this is a real burner. Number four, lying hamstring curl, play loaded. We're gonna do two sets again. One is gonna be 6 to 8, and the other one is gonna be 10 to 14. Exercise number five and tip number two is the hex squat. That's the exercise. And the tip is, pick an exercise for quads that allows you to go through the biggest range of knee flexion, right? So you can get length from the quads, so you can get more range of motion out of the quad, and therefore you can get more mechanical tension, which is an important factor in building muscle, if not the most important factor. But, you know, a leg extension allows you to go through a big range of knee flexion and extension, but you cannot load it that much. So something like a hex squat, where you support it, you can load it. Now, a lot of people like to do back squats and front squats for their quads, which, don't get me wrong, that's an excellent movement, but it depends on you as an individual if you can actually get a lot of knee flexion out of that movement. Just to show you an example, let me show you one of my squats. Okay, so I can actually get a lot of knee flexion in a squat, still keep the bar over my mid. So for me, a freeway squat is a good exercise for quads. But now let me show you a different example. As you can see, she gets a lot less knee flexion out of the same movement pattern. But what if we put her on a hex squat where she is supported? Let's see if she can get more knee flexion. Okay, so as you can see, she gets a lot more knee flexion in this machine versus a freeway squat. And she can load up this machine as much as she can load up a freeway squat. So therefore, this for her would be better to train in quads. Now for me, because I'm pre-fatigued and thinking about my later sessions on in the week where I'm gonna do block pulls, loading the hip musculature, I'm also opting for the hex squat because it's back supported, so there's less load on the hips here and I can focus more on direct work for the quads, which is exactly what I want from this exercise. A bonus tip here, and this is with any squat or deadlift pattern, if you have shitty shoes like these for training, obviously they're not shitty shoes, but for training they are, take them out, because you're gonna lose a lot of force production if you're pushing if you're pushing through soft soles like that. Working set number one, we got 160 kilos here and we're going for 10 to 14. We got three working sets here in total. The first one is 10 to 14. After this, it's gonna be a heavier set of 6 to 8. And then we got a big set of 15 to 20 reps. Set number two, 6 to 8. We got 200 kilos on the bar here. We got a spotter.
Right one, the right one. One. Two. Come on. Four. Come on. Come on. Five. Push. Come on, no. Come on.
Okay, set number three. We got 125 kilos on now. This set is gonna be 15 to 20 reps. So we did 10 to 14 first. Then we went lower in reps, heavier in weight, 6 to 8. Now back up, 15 to 20, sort of wave loading. That's tip number three. It's not just for legs, it's in general for any body part. But get strong in all the rep ranges. Anywhere up from 6 to 30 is where you can maximize hypertrophy. So make sure you get strong in that full range of 6 to 30. But that counts for any muscle, not just the legs. So let's do this set. This set is almost like doing cardio. Thank you. Okay, number six, right? That's number six for legs. We're gonna finish the legs with calves. Another one that you don't wanna forget. Whenever training calves, I would recommend you don't use shoes again, because you wanna use the functions of your toes, because they play a role too in contracting the calf. So if you wear shoes like this, where the toe box is relatively small, you can't spread your toes, and you can't use all the functions of the calf. So barefoot or on socks, but really barefoot's better. We're just gonna do two sets, of which one is gonna be a top set and the second one is gonna be a rest plus set. So let's go. Okay, second set, a rest pause set. I'm gonna aim to fill between 8 and 12 reps again, and then I have two additional failure points after that. Bonus tip, don't train like a pussy. You know, use your sets, use your working sets, bring them all the way to failure. That's how you're gonna stimulate the muscle to grow. And if you do that, you don't need a crazy amount of volume necessarily. Maybe again, if you're a beginner, you don't have the skill of bringing yourself that close to failure because you just don't know what that feels like yet. You might need a little bit more sets to get the right stimulus in. But you, if you're already advanced and you know how to get yourself to failure, and do it, because that's gonna be way more effective than doing tons of volume. Now, I'm gonna finish this session with two more movements for back, because back is actually a priority point for me. So we're gonna do one vertical pulling movement, which is gonna be this arm strength ISO pull down. We're gonna do it single arm so we can get the lat just a little bit more shorter. And then we're gonna do a horizontal row for lat, more for the thickness, lower lat. Left side of it, And that's also gonna be single arm standing row. Those will be for another session. So check you guys back at home for a prep update. All right, we're home. Just wanted to give you guys a little update on how prep is going at the moment. Just, you know, just a little update, see how things are going. We're currently 14 weeks out and it's starting to roll. I'm seeing more and more people that are also going to do the same competition now popping up, which is, you know, mentally can be taxing, and it has been for me this week. So that's a challenge that I need to overcome, especially now that it seems that the competition is going to open up for more advanced guys as well, which is a nice thing because I get to see where I stand amongst those, you know, more experienced guys, and it's an extra challenge for me, and it just allows me to go even harder at this. So that's the good part. The other side of it is that it can get tough mentally. It can be very daunting, you know, seeing pictures from other competitors and comparing it to yourself. And this is a big lesson that I just need to keep focusing on myself. Just need to make sure that I do everything in my power to bring my best version and to make a statement there, and then to do some damage. And that's just what I need to focus on. So that's what I'm gonna do. It's been a rough week this week. Had some personal news that, you know, also interrupted my state of relaxedness. Don't even know if that's a word, but we still got the job done. I've had like one wobble this week because of this personal news. Still made progress this week, so, and we have plenty of room to still make progress in the coming weeks. And like I said, it's starting to roll now, 14 weeks out. So essentially we got 10 weeks to do the job, because that'll bring us to 4 weeks out. And as of 4 weeks out, we just wanna be in a position, me and Callum, where we know exactly how the body's gonna respond, and we can just repeat the same process week by week. And as he always says, it's like the last 4 weeks of prep, it's like landing a plane, right? And you need to make sure that doesn't happen in a stressed situation. So the body pretty much needs to be ready at 4 weeks out, so we can do things like drop cardio and lower output, so we can create more recovery tools there for the body, keep stress lower on the body. So in the coming 10 weeks really is when the hard work needs to be done. So that means we're gonna step up a notch. There's been some adjustments to the plan last week. I keep all my plans tracked on Instagram, so if you don't follow me yet, check out my page. It's up here. I keep my weekly logs in there with my nutrition, you know, my macros, my training split, my drug use. Everything is in there. There's been some adjustments this week, so we're definitely pushing a little bit harder, and we're gonna be pushing harder over the coming weeks. It will get tough, but like I said, I'm ready for it. Let's bring it on. This week was a hard one, but I'm ready for the next week. I'm ready to do another productive week and, you know, leave no stone unturned, especially now that I know there's gonna be more advanced guys coming. Like, I was already doing everything, but now I'm doing everything with that in mind. I just want to bring the best package that I possibly can to this stage this year. For now, we're just looking week to week. Like I said in the last video, every week for me, it's like 1 week out mentality. If I have to be honest, I'm not happy with how this week went. Like, when I say I'm not happy or I made a wobble, it's just a very tiny wobble of me having some extra carbs post-workout on one day where the personal news hit and was very, very highly stressed. But I picked it up after that, so that's been the only wobble now. But again, I want to do this perfect, so I'm gonna focus on keeping everything accurate and bringing the best version that I possibly can. So that's a wrap up for the video today. Next week I'm gonna show you guys a day of dieting, so stay tuned for the next episode of The Return. Thank you for watching this video, and if you haven't already, please subscribe, like, and comment if you want. It helps a lot, and see you guys for the next video. Peace.